Hello, my name is Kathy, and today I'll be introducing the Irish Dance Tunes for All Harps book by Sylvia Woods. But before I do, I wanted to tell you that I have a great many videos now on many different topics, and so I've decided to make several different video playlists so that it's easier to find the videos of greatest interest. So please check out my playlist page. Very often, when a musician buys a new book of music, they'll ignore the write-ups at the beginning of the book in favor of moving directly into the music itself. So part of this introduction will correct this issue. To begin, this is the introduction by Sylvia Woods. Welcome to the Irish Dance Tunes. If you already play this type of music, you know how much fun it can be. And if you're new to jigs and reels, you're in for a real treat. I have chosen 50 tunes for this collection. Some are well known by most Irish musicians and some are a bit more rare. They are all written in the keys in which they are most often played. I'm very pleased to announce that one of the finest players of dance tunes on the harp, Marie Ni Chathase, please excuse the pronunciation, provided a great deal of assistance in this endeavor. She advised me on different settings of the tunes and provided many of the ornaments. I am very grateful for her help. Here are a few suggestions to assist you in playing this lively music. Please be sure to also read Danny Carnahan's Fine Introduction to Irish Music. Different versions. Many of the tunes in this book have different variations or settings played by traditional musicians. Don't be surprised if your friends play a slightly different version of the melody or the chords. This is common. When a musician gets together, they often compare notes on their tunes and try different settings. If you're playing with other musicians, you'll probably want to adapt your settings to fit so that the group will sound together. You will probably also run across different names for some of these tunes, as well as totally different tunes with the same names. This comes from geographical differences and the fact that many musicians learn tunes without learning the correct name, and then make up their own title. These incorrect titles are then passed on to other musicians, and the confusion continues. As Brendan Breithnach mentions in his book, Folk Music and Dances of Ireland, one tune, the Perthshire Hunt, has at least 60 different names. Ornamentation. Ornamentation is very important in traditional Irish dance music. These tunes are never played straight, but are always ornamented with grace notes and variations, giving them their recognizable Irish feel. The best way to learn about ornamentation is to listen to lots of dance tunes played by various instruments. Since each instrument has different patterns that are easily playable, each has different variations of the same ornaments. It's very useful for the harper to listen to dance tunes played on fiddles, euillion, that's elbow pipes, and tin whistles, also called penny whistles. The ornaments used by these instruments are basic to most ornamentation. Many ornaments in this book are written in grace notes. A grace note should not be nearly as loud as the note it is accompanying. The melody note should always sound the strongest. Variations. Usually a tune will have a phrase, long or short, which repeats itself several times. These phrases will generally be played differently each time using variations and ornaments. You must hear the tune and listen for the similarities and differences in the phrases. An example of a short phrase like this is found in Morrison's Jig. The first, third, and fifth measures are all actually the same. The first measure is the basic phrase, and the third and fifth measures are variations. Another good example of this is Brian Boru's March. This popular harp tune has more variations than you can shake a stick at. Everyone plays it differently. In my version, I tried to use as many variations as possible so that you could see some of the possibilities. Actually, in each section, the first six measures are basically the same, except that they alternate up or down a step. You can use this setting to get ideas on how you'd like to arrange your own version. Some melodic ornaments include the following. The examples of this are at the top of the page. Filling in gaps between notes, changing the direction of notes, changing the order of the notes, leaving out notes. Ornaments must not throw your timing off. These are dance tunes, and the rhythm is of the utmost importance. If an ornament is ruining the flow of the rhythm, leave it out or use a different ornament or variation. Often the first line or phrase of a tune is played straight with no ornaments. Then each time a phrase is repeated, it is ornamented in a different fashion. These differences can be quite subtle, but they add to the overall pattern of the tune. The arrangements in this book include ornaments, but they are only suggested possibilities. Experiment with various ornaments in different places to make the tune your own. Don't use the same ornaments on the repeats as you do during the first time through. Add variety to your settings by using ornaments, and your tunes will sparkle with life. Tunes with no endings. As you are playing the tunes in this book, you will notice that some of them don't seem to end. They sound fine when you continue to repeat the sections of the tune, but there's no way to stop. This is because these dance tunes are often played in sets or medleys, one tune going directly into the next. The best way to decide on how to end is just let your ears and your rhythmic and melodic intuition tell you what to do. If it sounds logical and finished, it's probably correct. Some of the fingerings in this book may be unfamiliar to you, especially due to the ornamentation. Here are some of the usual fingerings you'll encounter. Sliding on the fourth fingers. Sliding the grace note with the thumb. Various ways of changing fingers on the same note. All of these are illustrated at the bottom of page III. I have a great many videos now on many different topics, so I've decided to make several different video playlists so that it's easy to find the videos of greatest interest. So please check out my playlist page. Well, that's it for now. To stay up to date with my latest videos, make sure to subscribe to this free YouTube channel by clicking the red subscribe button right below this video. Take care.